G'day, welcome back to another episode of Flames Footy Chat. As you know, I'm Janko Flames, and I will start off with a review of week one of the finals. So the first game we had the Roosters home to the Broncos. It was a very close game. It was 24-22. Roosters were lucky to win that after Blake Ferguson decided, I'm going to stop a 40-20, but Brisbane went in and scored, and then freak Latrell Mitchell came in on the stroke about 70 minutes in and beat a few defenders, palmed off James Roberts and got over the line and won the Roosters the match, which means we've got the week off. Yep, the second game was the Storm home of the Eels. That was another close game. Cam Smith's 356th NRL match. Storm got up. Yeah. Of course Storm got up, because why would they let referee Cameron Smith lose his 356th NRL game? So, to be honest, Parramatta were played very well. Very, very well. Just unlucky to get away. Unlucky to lose. Very unlucky. So, the third game, the Eagles, they're mainly wearing the Eagles, were home to the Penrith Panthers, home as such, and they lost. I don't know how that works. They played in round 26, Manly got up. Now Penrith got up when it really counts, knocked out Manly, and Trent Barrett has been fined $20,000 by the NRL. In my opinion, you keep finding the refs, but is that really going to do anything? If you need to fine coaches, obviously the refs are doing something wrong. And also, where does the fines go? In the NRL's back pocket. Why doesn't it go into training the referees a little more? And the final game of the review of week one, the Sharks were under the Cowboys. Again, Shane Flanagan got the $30,000 fine for a spray of the refs. Yeah, 15-14, Cowboys got up. Yeah. I've got no idea what the NRL are doing, and to be perfectly honest, it's turning people away from the game. Anyway, let's move into week two of the final series, or semi-finals. The Roosters have the week off, Storm have the week off. So Storm play the winner of Brisbane, Penrith. Suncorp, I'm going Penrith in this game. It'll be a very close one. I'd like to see Penrith get up and try and knock Storm off their pedestal. Because it'd be great to see Storm get knocked out of the finals this close. Broncos, they'll come out firing at home. It'll be a very close game. One side, not one-sided. Back and forth, back and forth. 4-pointer, 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 4-pointer. This will come down to 6 points or less. And the second game, the winner of this game plays the Roosters. It is the Eels home to the Cowboys. Eels at home. I think they've only lost one game at ANZ. Could be wrong. Dead Saint Saviour, fill me in. You know the thing, I should too, but I can't remember it. Eels are tip favourites. Cowboys, yeah, they got over the line by a point. No Bevan French, he's not back yet. Kacer Pritchard is named on an extended bench. So I'm going Eels over the Cowboys. Also, on a side note, the NRL are having crowd issues. Not many people are turning up to games. comment down below what you think that the NRL should do. Should they make membership more affordable? Should they, the price of general admission tickets go down? What should they do? Because I've got no idea. I've got membership, but for those people that can't afford it, like going to football, it's costing them $100 to go to one game. It's ridiculous. Anyway, that's Jenko Flames. It's Flames footy chat predictions for week 2 of the finals. Flames.